Hi. Have you ever imagined a movie you made with your own vision and creativity? It's like drawing a picture or a scenario with all your hard work and dedication. And then after in your absence, it got ruined by others. What if in the same time you lost the most important thing of your life? What happened if in the same time you lost the most important thing of your life, your children's? Nobody can handle this much of pain and trauma. But still, he fought against all the hurdles of his life, and now he's back again with all his visionary ideas with the Justice League Snyder Cut version. Yes. Today we are talking about the great American filmmaker, Mr. Zack Snyder. Mr. Zack Snyder, always known because of his hard work and visionary movies. The man who directed blockbuster movies like 300, Sucker Punch, Man of Steel, The Watchmen, and now The Justice League. No, I'm not talking about Justice League 2017. I'm talking about Justice League, his version of Justice League. In my earlier videos, I've already talked about the difference between the Justice League, which is gonna release in 2021, and the Justice League, which is going to be released in 2021. There's a huge difference between both of these movies. But if still you are getting confused about the 2017 version of Justice League and upcoming version of Justice League 2021, no, it's not a sequel. It is the original Justice League movie, which was directed by Mr. Zack Snyder. By listening the name of all these blockbuster Hollywood movies, I hope you guys have an idea now that what a great and visionary filmmaker he is. The best part of his direction is that the action sequence and the color tone of his movies were always dark and classic. Yes, this is the beauty of Mr. Zack Snyder's direction. Why? What is so special about Mr. Zack Snyder and his direction? If you guys have watched his movies like 300, Man of Steel, Batman vs. Superman, The Watchmen, all these movies were having a dark tone, a dark color tone, a dark storyline. And yes, the classic slow motion scenes of Mr. Zack Snyder's movie. So, what is so special about 2021's upcoming Justice League Snyder Cut version, and why it is re-releasing again, not on theaters, but this time it's gonna be visible for us on HBO Max. Yeah. So let's get back into the time of 2017 when he was working on his upcoming movie, Justice League movie. Okay. Right after the production, right after the completion of the shoot, the first rough cut of Justice League movie was around 4 hours long. Okay, it was the rough cut. Can you imagine a Hollywood movie, a Hollywood superhero movie in 2017? And he's talking about the duration. The duration is 4 hours long. How is it possible? Because, you know, the Warner Bros. Didn't got agreed on his decision. So they were having some argument. And in the same time, he got a very bad news about her daughter that she committed suicide because of drugs overdose. So because of this family problem and this mental trauma, he was unable to complete the rest of the part of his movie. So he left the movie, and in his absence, Warner Bros have done, they have recruited another filmmaker named Mr. Josh Whedon. So Mr. Josh Whedon have directed the rest of the part. Okay. So his job was to complete this movie according to his vision. What Mr. Josh Whedon has done, I don't want to say This, of course, he's a great director, and he have also directed one of my favorite movie, Avengers, the first Avenger movie, and Avengers Age of Ultron. Both of these movies are my favorite, and I'm also a big fan of Marvel Cinematic Universe. But Mr. Josh Whedon, that guy, he came from the Marvel School of Colors. Okay, so Marvel movies are all about fiction, colors, humors. So he tried to put some humor, killing of every scene. Okay, the never give up attitude of Batman. Okay, the iconic black suit of Superman, and the iconic slow motion scenes of Flash, which were shot by Mr. Zack Snyder. I already told you that Mr. Zack Snyder was always known because of his iconic slow motion scenes. And the other things were there, like Mr. Zack Snyder always, that guy is always visionary. If you watch his old movies, na, 300, okay, the production design of 300, and some other movies like the Batman vs Superman, the opening scene of Batman vs Superman, you guys can see the slow motion scene, the color tone, the acting, the performance, and also the music. It plays a very major role. Okay, I agree, Batman vs Superman was not a good movie. There are so many mistakes were there, but we cannot blame Mr. Zack Snyder for all these things, because that movie was also ruined by none other than the Warner Bros. Media. But there's a plus point about his movies, because there are so many people, so many movie lovers were there, who always used to say that, what is the actual problem with these superhero movies, because is that these movies were not as much as real. Okay, these movies were not as much as real. These movies were always it depicts a fictional world. And imaginary characters, fictional characters, there's no reality, there's no truth. Okay, so the best part of Zack Snyder's direction, that he always keeps a realistic tone. Now you guys will say that, Mr. Govardhan, why you are not taking the name of Mr. Christopher Nolan? Of course, Mr. Christopher Nolan, वो तो गुरुजी हैं सबके. Mr. Christopher Nolan is a great director, but if we talk about Mr. Zack Snyder, here we are not talking about a comparison. Today we are talking about the dedication and the never give up attitude of Mr. Zack Snyder. That guy have worked a lot, and can you imagine a superhero movie with a 4 hour duration? So many scenes, so many iconic scenes of the arrival of Darkseid. Okay, the scary look of Steppenwolf, the black suit of Superman, the best origin story of Aquaman, Wonder Woman, the never give up attitude of Batman. You can see right at the end of that Justice League movie, he delivers a dialogue that I don't care how many demons he fought in how many hells, but he never fought us. And now we are united. So you can see, you can get the goosebumps because of that. This is the actual Batman we are looking for. This is the version of Batman what we need to see. So I hope this version of Justice League, Mr. Zack Snyder's version of Justice League, will definitely do the justice to his direction and his hardcore fans like us. And I hope this movie will be the biggest blockbuster of Mr. Zack Snyder's life, and filmmakers like us will always been motivated and inspired from him. So I, Rahul Chatterjee, signing off, and best of luck to Mr. Zack Snyder.